I'm Edil.
I study mechanical engineering here in Aachen.
I'm in my 15th bachelor semester, and that's way above the regular.
Why did you choose Aachen?
That is actually a longer story. I just wanted to move away from home and experience something new.
Germany is one of the best places to study mechanical engineering.
RWTH Aachen is one of the best universities in the world. I wanted to spend my time in a slow city like Aachen. So I came to Aachen, and it's also nice that we are in the middle of Europe, that we can always travel to somewhere close to Aachen, like Köln or Düsseldorf or Holland, maybe Belgium, and with our semester ticket we can do it for free actually.
I checked the rankings and it was the best for the mechanical engineering, so I chose this one.
Do you actually participate in lectures?
To be honest, in the first semester I used to go to class every single day, 8:30 or like super like late in the evening, but now not at all.
Yeah, I try to. I didn't participate that much in my first semesters, but then I thought that something was lacking.
For me personally, it's not so helpful to visit the math lectures, for example. I just study for it myself.
What is the easiest subject?
I would say mechanics.
KOE, that's short for Kommunikation und Organisationsentwicklung.
I would say Einführung in Maschinenbau. It was a class from the first semester and it was like multiple choice, so I think it was quite easy.
Einführung in den Maschinenbau.
Called Einführung in den Maschinenbau. It's pretty easy.
It's basically every institute that you will meet during your studies. They come up and they show how great they are, what they do, how many branches there actually are to mechanical engineering.
So I've been told that it's Einführung in den Maschinenbau. It's like an introduction course for mechanical engineering, but it was not that easy for me because I was a foreign student who doesn't speak German as my mother language. So I think easiest one is AutoCAD.
Okay, and what is the hardest subject and why?
Maschinengestaltung, also machine design or Werkstoffkunde, material engineering, because there's just so much to learn.
Thermodynamics, because it's like micro points.
Thermodynamics, maybe?
Thermodynamics, definitely. Because it's two semesters packed into one exam. And it's a really difficult topic already, so many people fail at it. But it's still a lot of fun, even though it's hard.
Higher math, because they were quite intangible, if you get my drift. You just have numbers swirling around in matrices and in formulas, and you don't really know what to do with them. They're just there and you have to do it because the curriculum says you have to do it. And then a couple semesters later, usually, you run into a subject where you actually have to use that math, and the switch just goes, oh yeah, that was for.
What is your favorite thing about your degree?
That it is respected in Germany and all around the world, and that's it is a hard-earned one that you have to suffer for it.
Yeah, everything, actually, like the atmosphere that we study in with our friends. It's just a really nice experience.
You can study everything. Like, we have informatics, maths, physics, many fields that you can study and learn, and that's quite interesting, I think. I quite like it.
The best thing about mechanical engineering is your understanding of the world as a whole. There are so many things that just happen and you take them for a given, like wind howling around the corner of a building or perspiration or stuff like that. And then you hear thermodynamics and mechanics and it clicks and you say, ah, that's why that is.
How do you study? alone or in a group, and where?
I would say like about 95% alone and then 5% in a group maybe.
I used to study in the library because there I could study with friends in the group rooms, and then I will be more effective.
Because it's easier in a library to get motivated, stay motivated, because people around you are studying with you.
I like to study alone in exam period because I'm probably more efficient that way, but just studying with friends makes it easier and more bearable. So,
how often do you fail exams?
Never. Can we skip the question? My family will watch this video.
Okay, so technically I only failed once in my first semester, but I forgot like to cancel one exam and then I failed it because I didn't cancel it, so.
Well, the thing about RWTH is that if you don't study, you fail. So when I study well, then I can pass, but if I study like maybe the half of the subject or not very well, then of course I fail.
Actually, I haven't failed one yet, but that is to come. For sure, this semester. I know it.
How did you meet your friends?
Through the Students Council, every single one.
Well, I met a lot of people in my Estival here, first freshman's week.
Many of them during the pre-courses, before university actually started for us. We already met a few people and went partying and stuff. And it's where you start getting to know a lot of people, and
there's also the university sport, which is also a great opportunity to meet new people.
Also, in my first week of lectures, I tried not to be so shy and say directly hi to the person next to me. So I made lots of my friends in my first weeks.
Did you make new friends during Corona?
Not really, no.
Wait, let me think. No.
Probably.
No, not many, but there are some applications for it actually, but no, it's harder to make friends in Corona.
Obviously, it is harder to make friends during Corona, but I think for first semesters, there's still a very good offer to meet many new people.
Are compulsory or non-compulsory internships available?
They're necessary. You have to do a basic internship before you start with the studies. That's, it's 6 weeks, but of course you can extend that.
And in the studies, after you complete your exams and everything, we have like, I guess, 16 weeks of practicum, and it's internship in English, and it's also compulsory to finish the degree.
And other than that, you can always find non-compulsory internships through organizations like bonding, etc.
What is the ratio of theory to applied implementations?
I would say we have a lot of theory. Well, there's only theory, actually. Maybe in the later semester we have to do an internship, but so far it's only theory.
The ratio is abysmally leaning towards theoretical implementation. There is one single subject in our entire curriculum, in bachelor curriculum, where you actually have to attend, and that's a metrological laboratory, where you just sit down and measure a couple of things with different implements.
There are two kinds of universities in Germany, the Fachhochschule and the normal universities. And in universities, you really go hard on theory.
But usually it's lectures and then some more lectures and then some more lectures. And you're still quite well connected to the practical aspect of it all, because it's mechanical engineering. It's quite a practical subject on a whole. And if they can, they do experiments on the stage and they bring exhibits. But as a whole, it's highly, highly theoretical.
It's still balanced because we do the internships, and I personally like it that way.
Okay, so you feel like it's enough?
Yeah.
I would say because it's only theoretical so far, there's not much practical stuff going on. So it's not enough, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like you need to set like a decent basis to do some practical work later on. So it's good like it is, I would say.
How prepared are you for real life?
Well, so far not really, but you know, it's like a long-term process, so I'll still study like, I don't know, 4 more years probably, so hopefully by that time I'll be ready.
Right now, not really, because I'm in my third semester. We are now learning the basic stuff, I think, only the theory, but after I started my Vertiefung or I start doing my internship, I will be more prepared and ready for the real career life.
I mean, real life as engineering? I don't know. But real life, as my real life, I think I'm quite ready because I live alone for like now 4 years, 5 years even. So I think I'm quite well prepared.
I consider myself quite well prepared for real life. Mostly though, because of extracurricular activities. As I said, I worked in the Students Council for 4 years and I learned so much about interaction, team building and team organization. And while I certainly believe that I learned quite a lot during my studies, the preparation for real life comes with the extracurricular stuff.
How many semesters do you actually need?
Technically 7, but who knows? We'll see.
Can we skip this one?
Okay.
7 semesters are calculated, but get that out of your head.
What it usually takes is upwards of 9 semesters. Your average student finishes, I think, after 9 or 10.
Mm-hmm.
And only about 10% finish in the 7th semester that the university says a degree is supposed to take.
Mm-hmm. What other extracurricular activities does your course of study offer?
For myself, I learned Italian for a year, like 2 years ago.
Our institute is actually offering lots of competitions or like some challenges that we can participate.
Our university offers a really wide sports program. You can just check it out on the website. There's so many different sports you can sign up to.
From the university sport, mm-hmm. Definitely if you're into table tennis, then play table tennis.
There are quite a lot of mechanical engineering students in Aachen, and thus there is quite a lot of extracurricular activities for mechanical engineering students. For example, we have Sonnenwagen in Aachen, where they build a solar-powered car and where they actually race that across the Australian desert. There is Écurie, where they build a Formula One car. There are flight courses, and if you're don't want to even think about your studies when you're doing extracurricular stuff. There are theater groups, there are choirs, there are bands, and there's of course the ability to engage with the faculty, to participate in the Students' Council and do stuff for your fellow students, like organizing parties and offering consultation hours, which is what I did.
Okay, that was my next question. So what do you do outside of university?
Except the corona time, I used to go to party a lot, meet with friends, and yeah, taking just a random walk in Aachen is a small city. I mean, it doesn't offer a lot, to be honest. But when I had time, I used to travel to Belgium with friends because we had a train ticket. And if you're under 26, to go and to come back, it costs just like 16 euros. So with that one, I traveled a lot and I enjoyed my time.
I was playing volleyball in my first semester in the sports center of the university, and I was going to gym so often, but now I can't. But now I'm taking English courses online from the Sprachzentrum of the university.
Things I love to go bouldering, for example. Here in Aachen, there's a pretty good climbing hole. And yeah, that's what I really enjoy.
Well, I'm just chilling.
What's your favorite bar then?
Retzel or Papillon? Not sure.
There's many favorite bars. It's hard to say which one's the best, honestly. I guess Sowieso is nice. It's here at the Pont Street, Pontstraße. There's also an Irish pub around the corner. The Philharmonie, they're all really nice places to go.
The Pontstraße, they are very cheap and actually very good. So I can recommend every bar.
Die Kiste. That's a small little pub in downtown Aachen, close to the Bachkalb statue. It's really, really small. I think the room we're in at the moment is smaller. It's bigger than Die Kiste. And they have a discount on Weizen every Monday. And they play heavy metal, they play Maiden and Sabaton and Powerwolf, and that's always nice. And it is the local for the Students Council. Usually every Monday, the older generation from the Students Council would meet there, have a blast.
I think it's Café Extrablatt near Rathaus, because they have really great cocktails. And they have also some happy hours. I saw that was an advertisement. I hope I will get a free cocktail after Corona.
The nightlife is like also like small, but I would say cozy. So my favorite one is, I guess, Bar zu Hause. I used to go there very often the first semester because they had like the social drinking. It's like an Erasmus event, and on Mondays, it was on Mondays. You go there and you have some drinks with people, you just chat, you play cards, or just like chill there with new people, and I used to love it there.
If you could go back in time, would you choose Aachen again?
Oh man.
Yes, I would, and I would maybe join the Students Council 2 years earlier than I did.
Yeah, probably yes, yeah. Because I feel like it was like a good decision to move away from home and then experience my own things, you know. So if I would have stayed at my home, it is good like it is, I would say.
Yes, I love my university. But if there was a time machine and I could travel back in time, I might have chosen. I would probably choose a university which is kind of a little bit easier and come here for masters. I mean, the thing is that, at least for mechanical engineering, when you study in another university, they mostly ask you to retake big exams like thermodynamics or the other subjects, but still, it will be kind of more convenient, at least for me, so I would choose some other ones.
Yeah, I would definitely choose Aachen. I had applied to other universities in Germany, like Technical University of München and Berlin, but I really think Aachen is the best place to concentrate on your studies and also take place in interesting stuff that is connected to your degree. And also, as a Ausländer, as an international student, I really enjoy a lot of stuff that are just in Aachen and not that you can't find anywhere.
Yes, I will.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. I love it here. It's nice.
Okay, that's great. Thank you. That's it.